زيارات.
Please be seated. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Praise be to Allah, Lord of the universe. May peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and upon his family and esteemed companions. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Indonesia, His Excellency Mr. Joko Widodo, Your Royal Highness, Excellencies, Heads of State and Heads of Government of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation Countries, Vice President of the Republic of Indonesia, His Excellency Mr. Muhammad Yusuf Kalla, we are also honored to be joined by the fifth President of the Republic of Indonesia, Her Excellency Mrs. Megawati Sukarnoputri, the sixth Vice President of the Republic of Indonesia, His Excellency Mr. Tri Sutrisno, the 11th Vice President of the Republic of Indonesia, His Excellency Professor Dr. Budiono. Welcome to all heads of state institutions, Secretary General of the OIC, OIC ambassadors and ministers, Governor of Jakarta, honorable delegates of the summit, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. May peace be upon us all. Allow us to extend our warmest and heartiest welcome to Jakarta, the capital city of Indonesia, the melting pot of the nation, the center of trade and business activities. Welcome to the opening ceremony of the fifth extraordinary OIC summit on Palestine and Al-Quds Al-Sharif. This important gathering draws the theme United for Just Solution. To start this auspicious occasion, let us glorify the great names of Allah, the recitation of the verses of the Holy Al-Quran, Surah Fussilat, verses 33 until 35 by International Quarry of Musabakoh Tilawatil Quran in Jakarta 2015, Mr. Zainal Abidin.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين. ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة، ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. صدق الله العظيم.
Ladies and gentlemen, the chair of the 5th Extraordinary OIC Summit on Palestine and Al-Quds Al-Sharif, the President of the Republic of Indonesia, His Excellency Mr. Joko Widodo.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yang Mulia,
Your Excellencies,
para kepala negara dan pemerintahan,
heads of states and heads of government,
yang terhormat para ketua delegasi,
distinguished head of delegates,
ibu dan bapak hadirin sekalian,
distinguished ladies and gentlemen,
puji syukur malih kita panjatkan,
praise be
kehadirat Allah Subhanahu wa taala, selawat dan salam bagi Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu alaihi wasallam, diawali dengan lantunan ayat-ayat
beginning
suci
with the recital of the
Al-Qur'anul Karim.
Holy
saya nyatakan konferensi tingkat tinggi luar biasa kelima organisasi kerjasama Islam OKI mengenai Palestina dan Al-Quds Al-Sharif secara resmi dibuka.
Officially open.
Sebelum kita mendengarkan pandangan dan sambutan. Mohon perhatian yang mulia sekalian pada pemilihan Biro KTT ini. Setelah berkonsultasi dengan sekretariat OKI dan sejumlah negara, perkenankanlah saya menyampaikan komposisi Biro KTT luar biasa kelima OKI yang terdiri dari Presiden Republik Indonesia selaku Ketua dan Tuan Rumah KTT, Yang Mulia Presiden Sudan, Yang Mulia Presiden Palestina, dan Yang Terhormat Wakil Tetap Duta Besar Chad untuk OKI di Jeddah. Jika tidak ada keberatan dari Yang Mulia sekalian, maka komposisi Biro KTT luar biasa kelima OKI dengan ini kami sahkan. Pada acara pembukaan KTT luar biasa OKI yang kelima ini, kita akan mendengarkan beberapa sambutan dan pandangan. Pertama, saya mengundang Yang Mulia Sameh Shoukry, Menteri Luar Negeri Republik Arab Mesir, selaku perwakilan dari Ketua KTT ke-12 OKI untuk menyampaikan sambutannya. Kepada Yang Mulia, waktu dan tempat saya persilahkan.
The floor is yours.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Fakhamat al-Rais,
Judu, Indonesia.
Fakhamat al-Rais, Mahmoud Abbas, Dawlat Palestin. Ali Doktor, Iyad Madani, Amin Aam, Munazamat Al-Ta'awun Al-Islami.
Ashab
al-Sumu,
Your Excellencies,
Wal-Ma'ali,
Wa-Sa'ada, Wa-Khama.
سيدات والسادة
الحضور
شرفني
أن
أنقل
البيان
التالي نيابة عن
الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي
الذي كان يتطلع
المشاركة في هذه القمة الهامة لأنه حالة من ذلك
ارتباطاته
مهمة وأرض الوطن
وأقتبس
at home.
بداية
أود أن أعبر I'd like to convey to you
my
heartfelt thanks and appreciation to the government of Indonesia for hosting the extraordinary summit. And we are fully confident that this will be a major milestone in enhancing the solidarity amongst our countries and supporting the Palestinian cause and extending our backup to the Palestinian people who are steadfast against the brutal Israeli occupation and in the face of the recent developments on the Palestinian territories. I would like also to avail myself of this opportunity to reiterate Egypt's full confidence and belief in the right of Palestinians to achieve their rights, foremost of which their freedom and independence and the establishment of their state on the boundaries of 1967 with Al-Quds as its capital, and resolving the issue of Palestine in accordance with international resolutions. And despite the complexity of the issue in the Middle East, the cause of Palestine remains at the forefront of the attention of the Arab and Islamic world and represents a cornerstone in our policies towards achieving a just and fair solution for the Palestinian cause, which is the key for peace and security in the region. Egypt cautions against the activities perpetrated by the Israeli occupation within the framework of expansion in the West Bank, and wish to reiterate that settlement remains as the major obstruction against the progress of peace and the achievement of the two-state solution, which is the major cornerstone for the achievement of peace amongst the two parties. I wish also to refer to the grave nature of the activities undertaken in demolishing and aggressing the Palestinians and their property at the hands of the settlers. Egypt expresses its deep concern over the aggressions and assault against the holy city of Al-Quds, Jerusalem.
وطمس تراثها الثقافي والإسلامي
attempt to obliterate its Islamo-Christian character and identity
and
their attacks against the Palestinians,
the
demolition of their homes, their eviction, and the issue of laws and legislations to deprive them and deny them of their national identity. The city of Al-Quds, Jerusalem, is going through a brutal aggression and assault.
حيث يسعى الاحتلال الإسرائيلي
As the Israeli occupation is trying to isolate it culturally, economically, and financially, in addition to the continued action to isolate it with the apartheid wall.
The
occupation forces have continued their aggression against the Palestinian people in Al-Quds, Jerusalem, through the intensification of excavation works under the Holy Mosque and the continued settler aggression against the Palestinians with the protection of the police and security Jewish forces along with the restraints against the Muslim worshippers, a policy that is aimed at establishing a new fait accompli as has been the case with the Ibrahimi Mosque. I wish to call attention to the importance of extending support to the Jerusalemites, the
Jerusalemite Palestinians who are
facing the most brutal attacks in terms of the continued Judaization efforts. And we need to support them in their steadfast resistance by extending to them additional resources to continue their resistance on their territories and to enable them to maintain their properties.
And
we need to help them establish programs together with the Palestinian authorities.
Ladies and gentlemen,
our people in Gaza are subjected to the most brutal forms of aggression that have resulted in humanitarian crises that have been witnessed by all, particularly with the continued Israeli siege imposed on Gaza over the past 88 years, and Egypt is doing its best despite its own internal difficulties despite all this, Egypt is intent on contributing to supporting the Palestinians and help the extend relief. Egypt appeals to all the donor parties to commit and honor their pledges towards Palestine for the rehabilitation of Gaza.
Pledges
that were taken in October 2011. Also, Egypt calls for the need to intensify Islamic action, joint Islamic action to impress upon Israel to lift the blockade against Gaza and to insist on maintaining the identity of Jerusalem and also to open the passageways and to
offer
assistance to the Palestinians. The situation in Palestine is continuing in its downward way and it's deteriorating. We need to revive the peace process so as to achieve the final solution that is on the basis of the two-state solution. In conclusion, allow me to reiterate and underline the efforts put in by all of us to maintain the Palestinian cause present in the mind of the international community. We are thankful to all those who participated in organizing this summit and to Indonesia for the organizing and hosting this summit. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Terima kasih yang mulia atas sambutannya.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for your remarks.
Sekarang perkenankan saya dalam kapasitas saya sebagai ketua KTT luar biasa OKI sekaligus tuan rumah KTT untuk menyampaikan pidato. بسم Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yang mulia Tuan Mahmud Abbas, Presiden
Negara
Palestina. Yang mulia Tuan Iyad Amin Madani,
Sekretaris Jenderal
Organisasi Kerjasama Islam. Yang mulia Menteri Luar Negeri Mesir,
Foreign Minister of
selaku
Egypt,
Wakil
Ketua
KTT UKI
ke-12, the 12th OIC Summit.
Yang mulia, yang saya hormati,
His Excellency,
Presiden kelima Republik Indonesia,
President of the
Ibu Megawati Soekarnoputri,
Mrs. Megawati Soekarnoputri,
yang saya hormati, Wakil Presiden ke-6,
the 6th President of the Vice President of the Republic of
Indonesia,
Bapak Tri Sutrisno,
dan Bapak Budiono,
and Mr. Budiono,
yang saya hormati, Ketua Lembaga Tinggi Negara,
Excellencies, heads of state institutions,
yang mulia para kepala negara dan kepala pemerintahan serta ketua delegasi negara-negara anggota kerjasama Islam, para yang mulia hadirin yang saya hormati.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen.
Pada tahun 1962,
in 1962,
Bapak Bangsa Indonesia,
our founding father,
Presiden pertama Republik Indonesia,
the first president
Soekarno,
of the Republic of Indonesia, Soekarno,
Bung Karno, menegaskan,
clearly stated,
selama kemerdekaan bangsa Palestina belum diserahkan kepada orang-orang Palestina, maka selama itulah bangsa Indonesia berdiri menantang penjajahan Israel. Kami bangsa Indonesia konsisten dengan janji tersebut. Hari ini, Indonesia berdiri bersama dengan negara-negara UKI untuk meneruskan perjuangan yang belum selesai itu.
Struggle.
Suatu kehormatan bagi rakyat dan pemerintah Indonesia untuk memenuhi himbauan saudara kami, Presiden Mahmud Abbas, dengan menjadi tuan rumah konferensi tingkat tinggi KTT luar biasa dari Organisasi Kerjasama Islam tentang Palestina dan Al-Quds Al-Sharif. Selamat datang di Indonesia.
Welcome to Indonesia.
Negeri indah yang mempunyai umat Islam terbesar di dunia. Negeri demokratis nomor 3 di dunia. Negeri yang segera membuka konsulat kehormatan di Palestina. Yang mulia para hadirin sekalian.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen.
Kita dan dunia prihatin dengan memburuknya situasi di Palestina sekarang. Banyak kebijakan sepihak dan ilegal, serta hukuman kolektif Israel semakin menyulitkan rakyat Palestina. Akses umat Islam ke Masjid Al-Aqsa di Yerusalem juga dibatasi. Rakyat Palestina semakin tidak berdaya, situasi kemanusiaan di wilayah pendudukan semakin memburuk. Situasi tersebut harus bersama-sama kita hadapi. Kita harus bersatu. Palestina harus bersatu. Palestina harus rekonsiliasi.
Dan
Indonesia siap membantu proses rekonsiliasi ini. Yang mulia para hadirin sekalian, UKI dibentuk karena adanya kebutuhan mendukung perjuangan Palestina. Untuk itu, sesuai dengan tema KTT, United for a Just Solution, UKI harus menjadi bagian dari solusi. Apabila UKI tidak bisa menjadi bagian dari solusi Palestina, maka keberadaan UKI tidak menjadi tidak relevan lagi, sekali lagi menjadi tidak relevan lagi. Yang mulia para hadirin sekalian, batas toleransi masyarakat internasional terhadap keberlanjutan pendudukan ilegal Israel atas wilayah Palestina sudah lama berakhir. Sebagai bagian dari masyarakat internasional, Israel harus segera menghentikan aktivitas dan kebijakan ilegalnya di wilayah pendudukan. Indonesia dan dunia Islam siap melakukan langkah-langkah konkret untuk terus mendesak Israel mengakhiri penjajahannya atas Palestina dan menghentikan kesewenang-wenangan di Al-Quds Al-Sharif. Dunia Islam membutuhkan dukungan dari PBB sesuai dengan peran dan tanggung jawabnya. Dunia Islam kembali menyerukan agar proses perdamaian jangan ditunda-tunda lagi untuk mewujudkan kemerdekaan Palestina melalui solusi dua negara. Yang mulia para hadirin sekalian, saya ingin mendengarkan pandangan para yang mulia kepala negara dan pemerintahan serta ketua delegasi mengenai berbagai pandangan saya tersebut. KTT ini merupakan momentum penting bagi dunia Islam merespon situasi yang dihadapi rakyat dan bangsa Palestina dewasa ini dengan langkah konkret. Indonesia akan selalu berada di garis terdepan dalam mendukung perjuangan rakyat Palestina. Perkenankan saya menyampaikan bahwa Indonesia telah menunjuk Nyonya Maha Abu Susin selaku konsul kehormatan Republik Indonesia untuk Palestina, serta dalam waktu dekat akan meresmikan kantor konsulat kehormatan Republik Indonesia di Ramallah, Palestina. Semoga Allah Subhanahu wa taala memberikan ridho-Nya agar KTT ini menghasilkan kesepakatan nyata untuk segera merealisasikan hak-hak sah bangsa dan rakyat Palestina. Terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.